I think what makes us really different from other groups is that most other groups in this area are engineering teams based in a university engineering department, collaborating with external clinicians, whereas because of our health sciences school, there are actually clinicians, there's physiotherapists, prosthetists, etc., in the same university school. So the collaboration's much closer. They're down the corridor, not in a hospital at some distance. So I think that's what makes us really different.
I'm looking into myoelectric prostheses and trying to understand what it is that makes them difficult for people to control. A myoelectric prosthesis is controlled using the signals that are generated in your muscles, which are then used to operate motors within the hand to allow that hand to open and close.
We're using advanced motion sensors, inertial sensors, to measure the movement, to characterise the skill of the person. We're trying to understand the effect that a poor-fitting socket has on function. And we're also using activity monitors to actually get objective data on how people use these devices in everyday life.
So we are here in the Activities of Daily Living flat at the University of Salford, and we gather our data in this flat because it is more realistic and real-world representative on users and on their devices, which is taking it beyond the hospital corridors during which they usually are trained.
And we hope that by better understanding the problem with current devices, we can better inform future technology development.
That everything we do could help amputees in the future, it could help people who had stroke in the future. So it's almost an obvious really that if you work in developing medical devices and rehab technologies that you get a kick out of it.